Alright, what else do we have in here? Teen Titans 2. Oh, I didn't even know there was a Teen Titans 1 on Game Boy Advance, so this could actually be good. Starting off with the language choice before the screen there, that's... Wow, that is an amazingly low-quality version of the title song. Oh, wow. Oh no, please don't let it be a video card. Okay, it's looking like a video game. Yes, it's definitely a video game. Okay, we're good. Alright, so let's see what we have. Oh, we have dialogue. And Eleanor do nothing at the moment, but I would bet that that is probably going to be switching characters once we have more unlocked. I had to get out from up there, but apparently not. Wait, what? Let me see. Is that okay? That's just a thing with... I guess because this guy is in the way. That is interesting. Also, we have a beat-em-up where... we don't exactly have many varied moves, which is really bad for it. It's like the opposite of what you want in your beat-em-up. Also, the wall jumping really sucks. Is there more up here, or...? No. Oh, great. Computer hacking. So yeah, I had hopes that it might be a good game, but it is not honestly looking like it's gonna be a good game. That should get put back into the cell. Okay, we can stomp on tiny robotic spiders. I don't know if that's really a good or a bad thing, but it sure is a thing. How do we get up to... Oh! Just like that! Okay. That was easy. There then. But there's still more level to explore. And since I'm really not going to play through this entire thing, I may as well at least check out the entirety of the first stage. Or, can't actually get back to see the rest. Ah, that's lovely. At least play through to a point where I get to play as one of the other Titans, but I have no idea how long that's going to be, or if I can really be arsed to play this garbage for that long. Thing in these. Okay, we have pizza. Something important in these boxes, such that they're. Yeah? Really? I'm always holding out hope in games like this. Especially when there's things that are, you know. There's a falling platform and a goon guarding the boxes, making me think that, hey, maybe there will be something other than a health up in here, but I'm very often disappointed. Never mind! We don't have a boss! Okay. I thought that big robot dude was gonna be a boss fight, but... dash along here to find. See what we can find that's not me falling down a pit. Because, you know, I love a beat-em-up in which you can, you know, just sort of run along. We have to find a computer to continue along. Really not good when they manage to screw up the wall jumping controls. Should be one of the simplest things. Damn it, gotta find another computer. Not that off already, game. There's no sound when you take damage. Okay, there is, it's very easy for the sound and the, you know, the actual indicator itself to be covered up by other things. Should not be a thing where, you know, I'm missing the enemy that much, and the enemy is missing me that much. It's just bad game design right there. Didn't think it was that. Had to check. Yeah. Jumping garbage. So if we do not find Cyborg either at the end of this stage, or the beginning of the next stage, I'm just gonna say screw it, because this is so not worth this. Yeah, this is so not worth this. Yeah, this has been Teen Titans 2, and this has been a really god-awful game. And the controls are bad, beat-em-up aspect is bad, the enemies can all be run past, and just everything about it feels just unfun. And yeah, the story's not that great, and the dialogue, also not that great. Maybe the other characters are somehow better than playing as Robin here, but I amazingly doubt it. I just want to check again in the action list, but I think I really missed all that much. Just that, which... yeah, that's... that's also terrible. So, yeah, no, I absolutely would not recommend this one. And we are completely done here.